just, as I was walking out, there was a door that was cracked, and I was like, I need to go in there. And I opened the door and just got like knocked back by this stench, and that's where I found Rama. She was just sitting there in a cage, hissing, just hissing in anger with like a urine soaked towel, and it just was really pretty bad. I sat with her and just cried, and then I was just like, I'm getting you out. And I told her before I left, I was like, I don't know how, but I'm getting you out. And I walked out just sobbing, and I was like, we need to do something. So many people were reaching out to me, so many people wanting to help, but like, I just felt distrustworthy. And then, well, I just felt mistrusting of certain ones. And then I immediately felt this like mothering instinct kick in. And every time someone was like, oh, we could take her, I'd be like, really, what are your intentions? And I would like feel myself like kind of grilling them. How big is her cage gonna be though? How are you gonna transport her? And just really getting like kind of spicy about it, because I was so committed to making sure that she had a good life. So it was really useful to be able to be working with people who had so much more information on it. Like, I've loved animals my whole life, but I knew nothing about ocelots, so much so that I didn't know that Rama wasn't an ocelot. I had made a post on Facebook, and my friend Ann Heiser tagged Mike, I believe, and so yeah, we connected, and he was instantly like very knowledgeable, and had something to say that wasn't like, oh, like bring him here or something. Like, he was like, okay, we can do this. It wasn't like, you should do this. He was like, we can do this. And so it just immediately felt like I had someone on my team, because before that it really felt like I was doing this alone, and I was like feeling really stressed and overwhelmed when that happened. And then I was like, is this real? Are they really coming? And then it's like a couple days later, you guys are here, and I was just really yeah, I don't know what I would have done, because I was very unsure about all of the different options that were being presented. And I poured so much of my heart into Rama that I was like, I can't make the wrong choice here, because like, if I do, she'll end up just nothing but a petting zoo life. And then what have I even saved her from? Nothing, you know? So it was really weighing heavily on me. And so you guys getting involved has been so helpful, because now I feel confident that we've got her to a facility that's going to rehabilitate her and give her a chance at life and freedom, which is what she deserves. Overall in life, I feel so often like we see something going wrong and we think someone should do something, and I think people need to remember, like, you are someone, do something, you know? Like, I had literally just arrived that day in a brand new city in a country that I don't really speak the language, and I was like, I'm doing something. I don't care what it takes, like, I will make an impact here. And because of that, you know, the whole world and the universe conspired in our favor and it all worked out. But it's like, it took me choosing to make an action, and I had no idea what I was doing. I don't know anything about ocelots. I don't know anything about the illegal pet trade industry. I just knew that I saw something that I wasn't going to look away from.